Welcome back to the Philthy Podcast.
Well, we only talk about Kessel. Oh, yeah.
Phil Kessel.
What's your favorite kind of hot dog? Greg.
Smoky.
That's a hot dog. Is a hot dog a sandwich?
What's a sandwich?
Sandwich.
Sandwich?
A sangy.
A sandwich?
No, sandwich.
What's a sandwich?
Oh, I just have to clear it.
No, this is the Kessel Podcast. We only talk about Filthy Phil's stats.
Oh,
over his entire career.
Oh, perfect. Okay, well, fun fact. I've already said this plenty of times on the podcast. Phil Kessel, Minnesota Golden Gophers, alternate jersey from when he played in college, number 26, was the first jersey ever saved up and bought with my own money at the Grand Forks Mall. Oh, I don't know what mall it's called, but it's awesome. And that sports store is still there, and it's sweet. It's top a notch.
Wait.
The one in the far left corner.
You bought a Minnesota Golden Gophers jersey in North Dakota?
It's college. They sell everything.
Okay.
They had what I wanted, and they supplied it, and I purchased.
Okay, fair enough. Mm-hmm. Last minute in episode 81. That is why we're dedicating it to Filthy Phil. And if you're here, you know, after that god-awful intro, Cam and Greg back here for a third straight week. Dan will join us and give us a lowdown on his scouting report, but you're going to have to wait for that at the end.
And you know how good our phone calls work. They work terribly.
Shit. The worst. And this is actually the first time I'll be on the other end of it.
Oh, you've never
I've
made a call?
I've always been
going,
the called in.
No, hold on. When I was
on the road. Good point.
And I was going to say, when I was listening back, I sound like Bill Burr over the phone. If you know who Bill Burr is, I don't know. But right on his podcast, I sound exactly like him. Well, maybe not exact, but really close. Because I remember you guys were like, I don't know, you asked me about the Flyers. And I'm like, no, Ivan Provorov. And like, I just went into my voice. I was listening to it back the next day. And I sound like Bill Burr. It's crazy.
That's
I thought it was cool. But, however, it's fun being on the person end.
Yes, it is. So we'll call him. Some other stuff about the show today. We're going to talk about the Jets. Not really much. They've lost four straight now, so we can't really talk much about them.
The tank is beginning, and it's great. I can't wait.
Some familiar faces from last season in the election.
What?
At the end of the show, yeah.
What do you mean familiar faces from last season? You can't get drafted twice.
Teams.
Okay. I'm confused, but good teaser.
Familiar teams.
Oh, teams!
Wow.
I thought you meant the draft, the election, like the players involved.
No.
Like, you can't get drafted. It's been not a long day.
And you can be drafted twice. It has happened.
Yeah, it's true. It could happen. But no one goes in top five. You get traded before that would happen. That'd be
just
funny.
Just saying.
Wait. Back that ass up. Can Jonathan Drouin re-enter?
No. Okay.
That'd be awesome.
That'd be hilarious. And we will talk about Jonathan Drouin, including other trade rumors involving Andrew Ladd and the other people on the trade block, as next week, Monday, is trade deadline, which means next time we meet, we'll be breaking down all the trades. So this is actually a very exciting episode where we're going to basically give a lowdown on a lot of trades that we think are going to happen, and then we're going to leave all the other bullshit stuff to the end. So calling Dan, talking about the World Cup jerseys and the preview.
We haven't even seen them. I have a
all we've seen is the previews.
But they look good.
All of them have three stripes on them.
Wow, I wonder why. Adidas?
Yeah.
K-Swiss, actually. The American ones, the case was barber pole. That's it.
Yeah. So after that, we'll talk about the Montreal Canadiens 1 million follower Twitter fiasco.
Oh, yeah.
But let's get right into trades right now. Let's just talk about the Jets. Elliot Freeman, you said, did an AMA on Reddit.
Oh, yeah, yesterday. So I'll tweet the link because it was very good.
Very good. So in that, he was talking obviously about trades.
Yep.
And the name Andrew Ladd came up. What was said about Andrew Ladd?
Well, they said the Jets definitely hold all the cards in this. The Jets have all the power in this. He said because I don't know if Ladd has a no movement clause or whatnot, but basically he said they were short answers. He said Jets hold all the cards, but I'm leaning towards he's basically played his last game as a Jet, which would have been last night.
So a lot of people were going into the last night's game against Dallas where they lost 5-3. An empty netter made it 5-3. It was actually kind of an exciting game. You know, I still think they're on that competitive side with Dallas. I still think they have that skill level to be competitive with that team. I just think they're a step behind because we don't have a Jamie Benn or a Tyler Seguin on our team. And they do. They have two. They're both those guys.
Yeah.
So, We just don't have that yet. You know, we have Blake Wheeler and Nikolai Ehlers is emerging. Scheifele's looking better and better every game. And, you know, I've been very happy with his improvement. But when it comes to this Andrew Ladd deal, some other trades that happened this week might influence what the return might be. Just to give a lowdown, Roman Polak and Nick Spaulding were traded from Toronto to... Who are they trading
to? The Sharks.
The Sharks. For two first-round picks?
Two second-round picks.
I wish it was two first-round picks.
That'd be awesome.
Two second-round picks, one for 2017, one for 2018.
Correct.
So...
And Raffy Torres.
And Raffy Torres. But he'll stay in San Jose's affiliate.
Oh, you can do that?
Yeah, well, that's what happened with Matt Fratton. Matt Fratton was traded from Toronto to Ottawa in the FNUF trade, but Binghamton lent Fratton back to the Marlies, and you can do that in franchises. So, like,
that's
if,
great.
Let's say if Matt Fratton was called up to the NHL, he'd get called up to Ottawa Senators and sent back down to the Toronto Marlies.
That's wicked.
So you can stay with your current team, which is actually nice to have, so you can kind of build something there. So teams can trade these guys, but they can leave them on a loan to these
teams. Well, yeah, because the Marlies are on pace for the most winningest season of an AHL franchise of
ever.
All time.
Yeah.
They have 0.796 win percentage.
They have the same win or similar win percentage to Washington, I believe.
Really?
Yeah.
Whoa, I didn't realize Washington was doing that good.
Well, Washington right now, I think going into today, was 43-10-4 or something like that.
That's pretty solid stat. Either way, even if you're around there, that's ridiculous.
Yeah. And the Marlies are like 46-9-2 or something ridiculous. And one of those losses is to Manitoba in overtime.
Manitoba, we know. They're just killing it right now.
They're
doing great right now.
But. Sorry, yeah. Going into action tonight, Washington was actually 44-10-4. And they're down 4-1 currently to Montreal Canadiens. So, obviously, Washington, one of those teams that's going for a cup. And I even saw today on That's Hockey with Gino Retta, putting a little plug in there for TSN.
Yeah, he needs it.
Yeah, he definitely does. That mustache knows no bounds.
It's killer.
Yeah. However, that they are the beasts of the East. There's nobody better than them in the Eastern Conference. I don't know if there's anyone better than them in the NHL right now.
Washington?
Yeah.
Not even close.
Do they add any pieces?
Yes.
Is Andrew Ladd a piece they could add?
I really want it to happen because then I could say I called it. Okay. But even if they don't, I still think they're good enough to win the
Stanley
Cup.
Now, this came up yesterday from... I was talking to some people because I always talk to people. He mentioned that two teams that are in on the Andrew Ladd talks are LA Kings and the Anaheim Ducks.
Okay.
Okay? Because when you think about it, Andrew Ladd has a very movable deal at $4.4 million a season.
Yep.
He said he could see Andrew Ladd getting moved to these teams, and then these teams that have a plethora of defensemen, like Anaheim, moving, let's say, Sammy Vatanen or Hampus Lindholm or somebody like that to the Islanders. For Hamonic, and Hamonic comes here.
Oh.
So he's throwing a three-way trade in there and thinking that that could be a possibility. However, my rebuttal to that was, I don't see LA or Anaheim giving up a top four defenseman to the Islanders, who are going to be a contender this year in the playoffs. However, they do have to go through Washington, and that's going to be a tough series.
It's no matter what, Washington, there's like a deal with the devil, someone made along the way, Ted Leonsis, where he's like, okay, you're going to have a great team year in and year out, but every year you have to play one of the two New York teams. I don't care which one it is, but you got to pick one, and they're probably going to take you to seven.
So if, honestly, what I'd love to see, and I doubt it'll happen, but if we could have a first-round series of Washington-Pittsburgh, and have Washington win just to refuel that fire.
Because I don't want to chance
that was,
it.
That was
it's
such,
too much.
But that was such a good rivalry.
That was great. Remember when they did dueling Hatties?
Oh, yeah.
I remember that. Oh. I remember like it was yesterday. It was a beautiful day outside.
I remember that game, sitting on my couch in my living room and watching that game and just like freaking out because I was such an Ovechkin fan.
Who isn't that Ovechkin fan? The best.
Yeah.
He's so good.
However... Let's talk about Andrew Ladd. What's the most realistic place he could end up right now? If you had to put...
Based off of what we've noticed at the last couple games, well, fine, I'll just go off yesterday's game. Stan Bowman was at the game.
And same
Chicago.
With... Stan Bowman was at the game, I believe, scouts from LA and...
Oh, really?
Well, I believe there are three different scouts at the game.
If there's
But Stan Bowman being there
I'll just
himself.
Go off the return. It's gotta be. If it were me, my line is for sure like a prospect, whether that's a B or C level prospect, you're not gonna get an A level prospect for a rental. Apparently, no. They were offered a first round, according to Lawless, which I mean, I'm sure he knows people, but like. A first round pick for Andrew Ladd.
Okay, but Bob McKenzie,
like that would have happened already.
Bob McKenzie said that every day that he's not traded, his stock is rising. So, currently, he's number one on the trade board.
Oh, of course he has.
And if Antoine Vermette can fetch a first-round pick, I think Andrew Ladd can.
Well, I was going to say...
I think Andrew Ladd's a more serviceable player.
It's at least a B or C-level prospect, and for sure, at least... I'm going to say second or third. Like, it's got to be and or a combo of both, or maybe even a player.
If you're the Chicago Blackhawks, or if you're the LA Kings, or if you're the Anaheim Ducks, or if you're anybody going after Andrew Ladd, who doesn't matter who you are, you're thinking, I'm getting this player to win a cup. So throwing away a first round pick means you're going to throw away a bottom four pick.
True.
So that's maybe their thinking there.
And
is
most
that,
likely the Jets could do a la what Toronto did last year with their late round pick. Trade it to get more picks later on or trade up in the draft. Toronto traded down.
Toronto traded down because they realized they could get Travis Dermott late.
Yeah.
And they got him in the second, which was really smart. And they got Braco. And they actually were smart there, and I was a little nervous about that. But there was speculation last year when Winnipeg had two first-round picks about them trading up. I think what would be smart, or what they could do, is they could if they finish, let's say they finish bottom five, and they have a top five second-round pick along with a bottom five first-round pick, they might be able to move up into the mid-teens.
That'd be okay.
With a team like a...
Boston
or...
Well, that's assuming they get knocked off.
Just because a strong second-round pick could be made there, but if Winnipeg is able to get another first-round pick, they might be able to get another Kyle Connor late in the round.
They better have a plan, though, too.
Oh, they...
Just because you don't want to happen what happened with Boston.
No, you don't.
Where... the rumor going around was they wanted those... We all know, but they wanted those three picks to... They were trying to get Arizona's third, so they're like, we'll give you our three for your one. Arizona's like, no, we don't need those three.
and then
Boston's like,
don't
book it. And then they went up, and there's so many guys on the board. And they didn't take any of the guys they thought they were going to take.
Barzell. They could have taken Barzell.
Connect me. I think.
Connor.
Okay. Mama.
Here's another question I have for you. The New York Islanders this season are one of the strongest. They're a strong Eastern Conference team.
Very strong.
Now, there is word through the grapevine that John Tavares could be on his way out. That they might move him.
Oh, because is he growing tired of, I don't know, playing musical chairs in an arena that doesn't work, and then like, or like a garbage arena, then moving to an arena doesn't work. They already want out of their lease. It's a 25-year lease. They want out. There's an out clause in year four of that. But until then...
The Islanders want out.
They already want out of the Barclays Center.
Is it that bad?
It's... Well, the attendance... Like, here, I have the numbers here. The attendance is... Other page, Cameron. Last year, 15,334 is what they averaged. This year, they're averaging 13,424. And that's including 1,500 obstructed seats where you cannot see the goalie on one side.
Okay. So, because, let's be honest, the Islanders have a plethora of strong centers that are coming up in Matt Barzell and Michael Delcol.
Okay, Delcol's a winger. He's a forward. Doesn't matter. I get where you're coming from.
Including Hosang, if he can get his shit together.
He can wake up on time. Come on, man!
Could we see a big splash like a John Tavares getting moved now, or is that more of a draft thing because they want to move into the playoffs?
Well, considering this is only the second time I've heard of this, first time was like 2 days ago when it was like on Reddit Hockey. It's like, Leafs are, or Leafs.
Apparently Leafs are getting everyone
now. Well,
yeah, they're getting Ilya Kovalchuk, apparently.
I haven't yet, but I'll ask you about it. It's like, Isles are considering moving John Tavares, Leafs front runner. I'm like, well, Leafs are front runner for any center right now, or who isn't? But... Now this is the second time, so I mean, big trades like that.
But they're talking.
I'd love to see it happen now, but I think it's more of a draft / off season. Considering the contract he's on, it's very movable and it's a doable trade. Well, I mean,
here's something
I'm on the
Leafs
side
more
than the Isles. I'd rather go ahead.
If you're the Islanders, and let's say you take what you can get, and you get Andrew Ladd for Travis Hamonic, and Hamonic leaves. But you need another defenseman, a very economy defenseman. So you go and you go to the Leafs. You say, what can we get for... And Leafs are like, well, we'll give you Nazem Kadri, Jake Gardner, and a prospect.
For Tavares?
For Tavares.
No. The number for me, if I'm Gar Snow, because he's crazy. Yeah. That mind. If you don't play in Gar Snow's court, we've talked about this, it's a no deal.
Oh, for sure.
First off, if they get Ladd for Hamonic, Gar Snow, you're insane. Don't do that. But say if this happened, my number would be, I'm okay with Nasty Nass. I'm okay with...
Gardner.
That's a first. I'm getting your first pick.
This year?
Yep, I'm getting your first. If it's Tavares, he's a number one overall pick.
I don't care.
I'm getting your first.
Fuck that.
If I'm... Well, then...
You cannot...
You have a franchise cornerstone. We're getting ours in your pick.
That's true.
What do you want? Do you want to chance your top five pick, or do you want a number one right now? And speed up that process.
I don't want to speed up the process.
Well, then, don't make that deal.
But could you imagine Nylander with Tavares as a centerman?
Nylander... They might even just say, hey, Nylander...
not trade Nylander.
Nylander and Gardner.
No.
For Tavares. And you keep your first. You get another. See?
Wow.
This is what trading... Oh, that's another thing. Okay, read the AMA for Elliot Friedman. Because a bunch of people were like... Well, one of the people who asked were like, how do trade talks work? And he's like... And he broke it down. And then like the top voted comment underneath was like, sounds exactly like my fantasy hockey trading.
Yeah.
And like, because it was basically like, oh, hey, you're really not doing that good right now. Could we take player X from you? And like, he really broke it down and just, that's seriously how it works sometimes. Or you're just calling to say, hey, what could I get if I gave you blank? And then that's where you set your market. You call like your most reputable business partner. So like to Winnipeg, I guess right now our best one would be Buffalo or Carolina based off the deals we've done with them.
Yeah.
So, or you just call someone and then they set the price for you and then you go from there. But it was really, check out the Reddit AMA. It's great. I'll tweet a link.
The other thing, so the media yesterday was going crazy about this being, last night being Ladd's for last ever home game. Has Ladd being moved more been a media hype than actual fact? Or do you think the Jets are physically shopping him at this moment just because they couldn't sign him?
I think the moment that they went public with the Bufflin signing, that was the nail in the coffin. Because what happened, we had podcasts before where we were talking about like Ladd getting moved, then everything went silent, and then boom, Buff gets signed. From the moment that it went silent, I think they were calling around for Ladd. And he's a guy that any playoff team, he's the guy, that's why he's a top trading guy, because he's won cups, he can play, he goes to the net, he's a guy you don't really want to play in the playoffs that much.
Hurt last year, and I think he was still one of the Jets' better players.
That's what some people were saying, they're like, oh, why would he play hurt? And I'm like, because he understands what's at stake, he's been there twice, he knows what the price is.
And that's why I think he was a great guy to have, and you know what, I think that this... He was the right captain for this team for the first 5 years. He was a great person in the community. He was awesome. And, you know, next week if we have to come on here and say he got traded, I will be thanking him for his services.
I think he's great.
I think he's been a great captain. I think he's up there with the Keith Kachucks. I really hope that maybe when the Jets are in a same bind, maybe they can get him as a rental player.
In a couple of years, what do you mean?
When they're going for cup number 4?
Oh,
in
6
years?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So when they're going for cup blank, I think it'd be 2 at this point. So in 2019, are you going to call them when the Flyers and the Jets meet in the cup final?
Oh, yeah. No, it'll be Leafs Jets.
Well, I'll meet you in the Eastern Conference final, and then we'll go from there. We're playing
the
Jets.
Well, you know how Toronto does against Philadelphia in the playoffs. They don't. John LeClair and Mark Recchi, they haunted my nightmares.
Oh, really? Oh, good. Well, we already have a pretty good duo. And they'll
Ghost
be near. No, Gossesbear? They'll be near the end. You know what's crazy?
And
Pete, you're talking about Gossesbear right now, or Ghost Bear?
Yeah.
But... That's overshadowing the fact that they still have Giroux and Voracek.
Yeah, I mean,
they're not terrible.
they have some of the... You include what? Gossesbear, Morin, Provorov, and who's their other defenseman? Don't they have one more?
What?
Don't they have one more?
Oh, the five. Okay, well, there's Gossesbear, Morin, Hag,
Provorov.
Provorov.
And there's that other
Morin.
Guy.
Why am I drawing blank on this? This is unacceptable, Cameron.
What's his name?
Yeah, pull it up.
I'm going
to
pull it
up. Okay, what are we trying to figure out again?
Kay. Oh, Toronto versus Philadelphia playoffs. And then we were just talking about how...
Oh, yeah, well, we're going off the rails. Okay, there's Ghost, Provorov, Morin.
I'm trying to think of his name. I'm trying to think of his name. His name's on the tip of my tongue right now. This is just prime...
Oh, podcasting. Travis Sanheim.
Sanheim. Yay! Okay. Yeah. So they're pretty stacked. Do you see Philadelphia moving somebody? One of their prospects to get upgrades?
Right now?
Not draft time. Are they somebody that could move... That could
for secondary scoring?
For secondary scoring. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Well, especially with the emergence of Ghost, why wouldn't they?
Is Wayne Train on his way out? Is he? He hasn't been mentioned, but is he going to be an off the board kind of guy?
I don't want to see it because I love him. But if there is to be one who gets traded as of right now this season, oh, as a rental this year? No,
no, no. Well, is he? Is he? How much time does he have left on his contract? Three years?
Okay, or three? I think. Maybe.
Do you think like a Nashville would go for him? Maybe. For just to add some scoring.
Yeah,
and
but
add
it's
some
what's
toughness?
Coming back is like, because right now, like, the huge difference in Holmgren to Hextall is Holmgren is in the Glenn Sather mode in his head of like, sell, always win. Yeah. No, buy, always win now. Hextall sat back in the wing and was mentored by Holmgren and took away from Holmgren, and now it's a shift in mentality where it's like, no, we'll wait. We'll wait.
Wait it out.
Look, Ghost is doing great. But hey, you know what? It's a down year. Don't be sad that it ended, like the streak. Be happy that it happened. You know? Yeah. It's okay. We're probably not going to make... The Flyers probably aren't going to make the playoffs.
No.
But they're also not going to just toss it in either. Now, could they make a trade to move up in the draft? They did it last year. I can't see why they wouldn't do it again. That is where I would see a Simmons or a Shen, like Braden Shen, get moved.
I think Braden Shen is somebody that is...
He's really emerged.
I think he might get shocked just because his stock right now is really high.
Oh, yeah.
Because he's playing well.
They're for every team's fielding phone calls. Like, why wouldn't you field phone calls? But I know off the top of my head, at least if it were me, there's four untouchables. You can pretty much name them. Ghost, Giroux, Voracek, and Couturier. So those are the four that aren't moving.
Okay. To talk about another right-handed defenseman on the Jets, Jacob Trouba. Still unsigned. Is he a potential to get moved?
Yes. Oh, yeah. I think so.
So...
Like, maybe not in...
Okay. Now, you were telling me before the podcast started that Elliot Friedman's AMA. What did they say?
Because someone was saying, like, oh, can you see, like, off-the-board guesses? And he said, well, not really off-the-board, but he's like, it'd be interesting to see if Kadri went. But then in the same answer, he said Trouba in Winnipeg would be intriguing as well, or something along those lines. He didn't confirm that Trouba's getting traded by no means. But if Elliot Friedman, like one of the premier hockey insiders, is saying it'd be interesting to see what would happen, what could they get? Because if you put Trouba on the board, I'm assuming more than a few teams would give a phone call and wonder what's happening. Well, what do you think he would get then? Trouba?
It depends if a team can, like, if... It depends if they're taking the role of seller and really, like... Here's the thing. The Jets have the power in this Trouba deal. You know, I know that you said earlier that Ladd with the Jets, the Jets hold all the cards.
Well, they hold even more cards with Trouba because he's a restricted free agent.
But here's where even more cards are kept for Trouba. Look at the other restricted free agents that are on the market this year, defenseman-wise. Hampus Lindholm, Sami Vatanen. One of the three of them is going to get moved. They're not all going to stay on the same team they're on right now.
I would say two of the three would get moved.
And I wouldn't be surprised if they can't get something done with Trouba that they don't call Anaheim and just swap these young defensemen.
Or maybe make a three-way deal again, maybe. But those are so hard to pull off.
Those are hard to pull off. But what I'm saying is, if they went out, they got Hampus Lindholm, let's say, they could part with Josh Morrissey. If they let's say they keep Trouba and they're able to get Hampus Lindholm, they could part with Josh Morrissey because Hampus Lindholm is left-handed.
Josh Morrissey doesn't have that big. I know we like him because we get to see him, but like, does he really have that stock value?
No, I'm not saying he does, but I'm saying then he becomes expendable.
Oh,
because he was going to be your replacement for Enstrom, but if you bring in Hampus Lindholm, that's the type of player that Hampus Lindholm is. Maybe a little bit tougher too.
Than Toby.
Than Toby.
Oh, that's another name. Toby.
And that's the problem is his contract, right? It's tough to move a guy with that much contract still.
5-7-5, yeah.
For another 2 years, I believe, as well.
I think so.
That was a tough deal. I don't really know what the plan there is. They might be able to get out of it. I'm not sure. They might just be able to dump it to some team that really needs a defenseman. You know, maybe somebody would be willing to take it. But that's the problem right now, is like the only team that would have the cap room for Tobias Enstrom would be like a Florida Panthers.
And are they really willing to take on exactly. that?
I don't think so. Okay, so Nazem Kadri is probably one of the most interesting names right now. You know, we mentioned Jacob Trouba, and we'll mention those other defensemen, Lindholm and Vatanen. They're all interesting names. Nazem Kadri strikes me as the most interesting because he's on such an interesting team right now, and his situation is like no other in the league, where they brought him in as a show-me contract to a team that is one of the worst in the NHL, where they were expected to be one of the worst, and they wanted him to succeed with not very good wingers or not very good players around him, right? And with JVR being out pretty much since December.
With a busted foot.
Yeah, which sucks. And Lupul being okay this season. And that's another guy that could be out the door as well as Joffrey Lupul, but his contract's a little high for what he brings to the table.
Well, if you trade Kadri,
yeah.
Who's
left?
Are you there night after night? They're icing. I know they want to rebuild, like, but like this is like 76ers levels of tanking. Like this is too much.
I don't know if it's tanking as much as it is stockpiling. I understand tanking, but they're stockpiling picks. They have 12 picks going into the draft right now.
Don't they have 15?
No, 12.
You sure?
The record is 13.
Oh, okay. I thought it was 16. No. Either way, they have way more picks right than now. Your team does.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And their goal is, yeah, they have 2 picks in every single round except for 2 and 7.
For now.
So I think they're going to continue to stockpile picks. They're going to continue to get guys.
Are they going to have the first 3 picks in this year's draft? No, is that what you're telling me?
No, they're not.
That'd be sweet, though.
But another team that, you know, like Nazem Kadri is an expendable asset in the sense that they could trade him now, get something for him, and bring him back again.
I don't know if that happens as much.
As much as I'd like it to happen, because I still think Nazem Kadri is a serviceable player, and I would like to see him succeed.
I don't know if this could work. It'd have to be dollar for dollar because they're right up there. St. Louis for Kadri.
I thought about that because Backes is on his way out.
Ooh,
but I don't think they'd be willing to move Backes now. That would be more of a draft move. So they do swap for swap. Kadri for Backes and maybe some.
But then if you sign back, like if you get Backes, you better sign him.
Well, that's the thing though, is they will sign him.
Oh.
But that would pretty much make him their number one center, and I don't know if they want to do that. That's the problem. Like, they're still going all out on Stamkos, I think. I think that's objective number one is Stamkos.
And objective number two is 91.2 John Tavares.
Exactly. And if that doesn't work, then yeah, they'll have to look other methods, but are they going to wait till the free agent market to solidify a number one center? Like, the problem that they have right now is they have so many freaking people that are apparently on the trade block that I don't know who's going to get dealt. Like, Michael Grabner is a name that's being tossed around. You know, they already got rid of Matthias, Spalling, Polak.
I think they need some AHL guys to just fill their roster now at this point.
Well, they brought up Brendan Leipzig, and boy, has he been...
solid.
Great. Josh Levo has been good. They have guys in their system. It's just, I don't know. Like, they got to get some players back and some shitty players at that.
Glad they're doing is they're not calling up arguably their best prospects. Which is, come to think of it, the Moose have not done either. The Jets.
They're talking that Nylander might be next.
No!
But
no!
That's just speculation. Not. And I think even Shanahan doesn't want it to happen. I think they're almost being like, what everyone wants them to do, they're doing it right now. Like, just, nope, we're not going to do it. There's so much temptation for them. They're staying away from it. They don't even want to touch it right now.
They don't want to think about it.
Exactly. Out of sight, out of mind for them. And I think they're just focused on getting the Marlies a cup right now. A nice Calder Cup.
Don't jinx it.
I'm not jinxing it. They want to get to the playoffs.
We all want
to
see it.
I know we all want to see it. But
Too bad the Moose weren't good enough. I'd love for them to get swept by the Marlies in round one so I could see it.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. They're not good enough, though.
No.
Who else is on the market?
Bigger names?
Bigger names. That you can see. Louis
Eriksson.
Okay.
He's an Andrew Ladd. He's a poor man's Andrew Ladd on the trade block right now.
However, has around the same contract.
Well, no, but I'm saying Andrew Ladd's number one. He's number two left winger.
Yep.
Or right winger, whatever, winger.
Who else out there is there a high possibility of getting moved?
I'm going to pull up a list because I didn't think you were going to ask me this.
I thought you'd be prepared, Cameron.
No. Top. What am I searching? Top.
Because there's a lot of talk coming out of Calgary that guys like Gary Hudler are available.
You know. Oh, Chris Russell. He's got to be.
Chris Russell?
He's got to be up
there.
He's
one of the top guys.
I think. Oh, man, he's good.
What does Edmonton do right now? What is their game plan? Are they going to go and...
Chiarelli said he's no one is safe. Well, except Connor, I think. But, well, that'd be awesome, though. Why have 91, Toronto, when you could have 97?
Somebody put that on a post. They're like, we're going to get Stamkos, then we're going to get Tavares, and then we're going to put something in Connor's drink to make him force a trade here and get Jonathan Drouin.
Said, oh, well, this doesn't work, really, the list I come up with. Thanks, but, American website. Stamkos, Drouin, Eric Staal. What do you do with Staal? They're in a playoff spot right now.
Carolina's in a playoff spot?
Yay. I think they're first in their division.
No, they're not first in their
division. They could be. Take a peek.
Their division is Washington.
Take a peek, see.
Their division is Washington.
Take a peek, see. They're in the playoffs. I think they're in the playoffs.
I don't think they're in the playoffs. I think they're one of the worst teams in their division.
They're in the playoffs. Well, they could be in the playoffs.
Nonetheless.
Who made this list? Okay, I'm calling out this website. NESN. Whatever you
That's
are.
That's the Boston.
Rhyme Time is on this list.
Yeah. James Reimer is apparently on the block.
Patrick Marleau?
Okay. Carolina is nowhere near the playoffs. Well, they actually are kind of.
Well, see?
They're 2 points behind Pittsburgh, but Pittsburgh has 3 games in hand.
Oh, everyone on the podcast, if we haven't made this aware, we're on Team Pittsburgh to make the playoffs. Because then Toronto gets a first-round pick. Another one.
They only have one right now, so that'd be two if they get it. Yeah, so Carolina is 2 points behind Pittsburgh and 4 points behind Boston right now. So they could make the playoffs.
Okay, here we go. Here's a list. I'm talking. Here's a list. Okay. Eric Staal.
Yep.
Andrew Ladd.
Yep.
Drouin.
Okay.
Hudler.
Okay.
Mikhail Boudker.
He's an interesting one, and he's somebody I thought the Jets would get last year at this time. Speed, like no one else.
Size.
Has a size. I just don't think he's a top end. He's not a scorer. He's a good possession player.
Allegedly, the teams that are interested. Panthers, Sens, Isles.
In who?
In Boatkin.
Okay.
So Panthers, Sens, Isles, Pens, Hawks, Ducks, Rangers. Any top guy,
Rangers, Pens. Why is Ottawa buying right now? They are nowhere near a playoff.
Because they're Canada's hope.
They're Canada's only hope.
Who's our prime minister now? Trudeau.
Trudeau
made a
They are technically 4 points out of a playoff spot. Pittsburgh and Boston.
And Carolina.
No, Carolina's... Well, they're 2 points behind Carolina right now. Nope. So who would you rather have?
Carolina. The fucking all-star, Justin Falk. Neglect Canada.
And Ryan Murphy.
No.
Yeah, and Ryan Murphy.
Ryan Murphy.
Wait, did I not say it? That Carolina would be a team maybe to watch out for because they have a bunch of
rising stars? God, screw you. You and Dan are like, guys, I'm sensing that this team with a bunch of young prospects... There's something.
Did I not say it
yes,
at some
you did,
point?
Yes, but come on. I can call things.
Nash, Rask, Lindholm.
You know, I'm not going out of my
Murphy,
way to say.
Hannafin.
The Golden State Warriors. They're a team to look out for in the playoffs.
Fuck you.
Yeah, see? Come on.
No.
Yeah, we know they're good.
But no one knew Carolina would be anything. Everyone thought they'd be shit.
Get the piss out of here. They've been so good. They've been coming
out. They have more wins than they have season ticket holders.
I was about to be like, really? Yes, Cameron, they have 29 season ticket holders.
They have 28 wins, so they only have 27 season ticket holders.
God, that'd be something. And then you just see, who's their GM now? It's not Rutherford, because he's driving Pittsburgh.
Brennamore?
Who?
Brennamore?
Is it? Well, he's just sitting there like, we're fine, I'm going to sit with the fans. Hey, guys. Like, And he wouldn't even let him have row, like section one, level 100. They're in the 300s.
I like what they've done in Carolina. Like, really. And maybe this is a time where they can move Eric Staal somewhere and get another top pick. Get another pick.
Staal is not the guy you want to target on the Canes. It's Jeff Skinner. You want
him. Yeah, Canes. You want Jeff Skinner.
There's a great article, by the way, about like, it was like just, they interviewed Jeff Skinner about his first year talking about players who, when you come into the league and you bust into the league at 18, now some players have never had a credit card or debit card. And it was like talking about how they talk to some agents too. And it's like, yeah, like some players who come overseas, they don't have banking, like, or like not even overseas, but they've just never had a debit or credit or anything like this. They have no line of credit. They have no like money to their name or anything. Then suddenly they have like thousands of dollars, millions. And Marian Gaborik, his first big purchase to splurge to himself was a laptop. It was a Sony Veo laptop or whatever. He went to go buy it at Best Buy, but all he had was cash or a check. And he wanted to write him a check, but he didn't have like ID or anything. So he had to go and get his agent. And his agent had to come with, well, think about it. Like some young kid who barely speaks English, who suddenly has to like, you could be, who like, he's like, no, I'm good for the money. I'm good for the money. Like that. What do you think? Drug dealer. That's what I think. Exactly. Like this kid's drugs.
Okay. We got to move on from trades. Top five. Who do you think is going to go for sure? Not going to be on their teams when we meet next week at the podcast.
Jonathan Drouin.
Top five. I said.
For sure. Jonathan Drouin. Andrew Ladd.
Okay.
I am going to say Dan Hamhuis.
And one Flyer pick. Like one just off the board.
Okay, I'm gonna name four of them Flyers. Dan Hamhuis.
No, like oh Flyers.
Yeah, yeah.
Like,
I'm going out on a limb here and saying that one of the Maple Leafs will be traded in the next week.
Okay, that's safe. The easiest safe bet ever.
Flyer pick, Mark Streit.
No, not like a rant, like an off the board pick, not a Flyers.
That's
player.
My off the board pick. Mark Streit. Off the board. Mark Streit, get that contract away from me.
Okay, so my top four would be Chris Russell, Louis Erickson, Andrew Ladd.
We're really stretching. Really stretching here.
Michael Grabner.
And top it up, PA Pervington.
And my Flyer pick is going to be. I'm just trying to think of like who would.
You know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna throw a ripple in the water.
Yeah.
Jacob Trouba.
Okay, that's a good one. That is a good
one. It'd be sweet to see Ladd and Trouba go together.
Oh, I know. Last week you said Sean Monahan.
Do it.
No.
Why not?
Not going Sean Monahan this week. No.
Did you see a Calgary Flame?
Valerie Nichushkin.
You know what? That's weird. I know. Why? Why would they do that?
Because winning now.
You're right. Who is it? Who do we?
Because if you can get Jeff Skinner for Nichushkin, would you not do it?
Why would you want Jeff Skinner going from east to west? You already see what happened to Edmonton. He had like a stretch for like 4 months where he'd come back, play for like three games, concussion. Come back, play for like 10 games, concussion. Like, his brain was just mashed a bit. Yeah, that's a great point. That's like, we've argued with Dan, because I remember Dan, remember he came with us at the Justin Bourne article, and he's like, guys, look at all the guys Boston traded away. And we're like, Greg, or Dan, it doesn't matter. They won the cup. They got it. They won the game.
They won the cup.
And that's what it's all
that's
about.
That's what you play for at the end of the year.
What you play to win the game.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. So on to some other fun
stuff. Do you follow the Habs on Twitter?
I don't follow the Habs on Twitter.
You should have unfollowed and followed last night, because boy, doodly did they have a dander on their hands last night. Wow! They had, to give you a rundown, they had an automated service on Twitter where whenever you, the trick is to unfollow and then follow them, it says, wow, thanks to the team, over 1 million, because that was their big, they hit the million mark on Twitter. So because it's the internet,
but no, okay, so the automated thing, what it did was, let's say you didn't follow them before, or let's say you didn't follow them, then unfollow them, then refollow them.
Yeah.
They would tweet saying, at your username, thank you for following, hashtag 1 million Canadien MTL, and put a picture of your Twitter handle on a Habs jersey with a 1M in the number. So, the internet being the internet, having the Twitter handles like I love ISIS,
and a lot of very
Habs suck cock,
a very derogatory comments towards PK Subban and people of that nature.
Yes, of African American descent.
Yeah.
Whoa.
African Canadian. That was a rough one. Someone was fired this morning, I'm assuming.
I'd like to think so.
Pay the extra money for the intern to just sit there for like an hour and be like, thanks, friend. Well, that's like, do you remember a couple years ago, 2014, with the Pats?
No.
You don't remember that. They're 1 million, or they're like, I don't know, it was a big number. Their follower, just follower. It was a racial slur. It was, I hate blank. And they were like, hey, thanks! And they retweeted it.
Oh,
and
no! Like,
oh, no! It went everywhere. Like, it was all over everything and everywhere. And it was like, no, what are you doing? Don't, just pay the extra. It's a crying shame that it happened. It's very avoidable.
Very avoidable.
You just do, what you do is you take the last, like, 100 names, you put it in a randomizer, and the name that comes out, you're like, woo, that's my millionth. Not even the true millionth. I don't care. So.
Yeah, or, you know, you just thank people for following you, but you don't use an automated system that puts their Twitter handle in it. Just say, thanks to all of our followers.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
If we ever hit a million followers, which will never happen, but if we do, on Last Man In Podcast.
We will personally, we'll follow you back, you DM us, we'll call you and say thank you. That's how it's going
to
work.
Or we just say thank you to all million followers. There isn't one follower that is above any follower.
Especially, and then you name one person.
Yeah.
Correct.
And if his name happens to be I Love ISIS, we'll change it to I Hate ISIS.
Boom. Boom. Yeah, we change. That's if we don't we like you, we change you. That's how exactly. That's a message we're
sending. If you don't conform to us, well, fuck you.
Exactly. Oh, let's just go to happier times. If we have any listeners in the San Jose area who can go to the game on March 28th, please send us a Brent Burns Chia Pet!
Oh, what?
What? Oh. Yeah, they're having a promotion. March 28th, the San Jose Sharks are giving away, I think, to the first couple thousand fans, a Brent Burns Chia Pet!
That's
and
awesome.
It grows hair and a beard everywhere. I'll retweet that link, because that's sweet! Cameron wants a...
Cam wants a Chia Pet.
I want a Brent Burns Chia Pet. I've never had a Chia Pet, but I want one. All right.
A Brent Burns Chia. That is the best thing I've ever heard in my life.
It is. I think so, too. Let me try and find it. And change it.
What else did we tease? I'm trying to think just to make sure that we don't miss anything. Oh, jerseys. World Cup. What do you think? What do you think of the teases we've got? Because, we're phoning.
We're phoning. It's too late now.
Is this Elliot Freeman?
It's our insider.
It's our insider?
I hope he doesn't swear anything.
Me neither. Well, what if he doesn't pick up? Because he's a douche.
Hey! Last minute correspondent, Dan Rudy. How's it going?
Good, man. What's up?
Well, just checking in. So how was your corresponding? How's our scouts doing?
Is
our future
scouting report?
Is the future looking bright for Last Man In? Are we going to have like a second line one day or?
No.
Damn it. How about, do we have any, like, feelers for a fourth line? Like, what is the future?
Wait. Do we have a famous broadcaster that might come on our podcast?
You know what? Never say never.
J-Beebs, never say never.
Paths were crossed. Connections were made. So, never know.
Yes. Now, I only imagine if we had a camera, could you... I imagine, Dan, when he does interviews, he's the Andrew Ladd death stare where he stares down the barrel of the camera into your soul.
Yeah.
Is that how you do interviews?
Well, right now it's more like the Andrew Ladd sad sob of death, but yes.
Oh, from a Jets fan. Is Andrew Ladd gone? Has he played his last game in Winnipeg?
I'm going to say yes, because based on how they broadcast the game last night, they made it pretty clear that it was going to be his last home game. They mentioned it every chance they could, and they asked him about it, and they interviewed him about it, and yeah. So, I don't know. Barring a huge turn, I think it's all but done.
Now, where were you for your scouting report, did they mention Winnipeg once? Just wondering.
Did they mention?
Did you hear anything about the Jets, or are they just non-existent?
Pretty non-existent. I mean, my Twitter feed mentioned them, but that's because I follow local Winnipeg media, so.
But nothing from the local area where you were? Like, no one gives a flying fuck about Winnipeg?
Not really, no.
Okay. That's not, as I expected.
Not many people give a flying F about the local team that they had there.
Oh, really?
What?
Interesting. Well, because it's baseball season.
People
care,
but yeah, it's all basketball, and I guess right now it's mostly basketball.
Really?
Yeah. I mean,
I don't want to divulge where he was, but
yeah,
like,
basketball's a big deal. I don't know what you're talking about. March Madness.
Well, March Madness is coming up.
Oh, I'm the one to mention.
Sure. NBA and March Madness, two completely different things. By the way, where he was, they don't do well in March Madness.
They do very well.
No, they don't.
They do, of course they do. For sure.
I'm not going to say where he was. Can we... No, no.
We'll no, it doesn't matter. You're on a scouting report.
You're on a scouting report. Are you going to be with us next week when we talk about trades?
I should be, yes.
We'll discuss when and where, obviously, later. You know, we're conducting wicked interviews. I like how we're super vague.
Question. What do you think of your basement? Do you like the new color?
I do. I heard you gentlemen were stand-up gentlemen and almost came out and helped, so thank you.
See, keyword is almost, because we don't help people.
No, we're assholes.
No. Now,
but you offered to help, which is almost better than actually helping.
Almost. Dan, do you have any what do you think is going to happen this trade deadline?
What do I think is going to happen?
Like, yes. Any big ones? Any? You see Trouba at the door. What do you see? What are you seeing?
Well, I was speaking to someone earlier who had said that they heard a lot of rumbling about him maybe being on the move, which I haven't heard anything of, but...
Hey, you can...
I mean... At this point, I'd say Winnipeg might be a team that makes a lot of moves. Not necessarily bringing guys in, but shipping guys out.
So are you okay with the tank?
I mean, at this point, the season's it's pretty much a write-off at this point. You have to think.
Confirmed, Dan is on Tank Nation with Greg and I. Welcome aboard, Dan.
Yeah, let's do it.
I'm glad.
If you're going to do it, you might as well do it now.
Yeah, exactly, right? Get that top five pick. Give me that.
You might as well go all in, too. Like, don't just stop at Ladd, you know. Toby, Stewart, anyone. I don't care.
Pamphlet, toss it in. We want least levels of tanking here.
Wait, I have a thought.
Yep.
If Winnipeg traded Michael Hutchinson to the Philadelphia Flyers, would Philadelphia have the first all-right-handed catcher goalies
in their lineup? That's a thought that's in your brain only. I didn't even know they had right-handed catchers.
Because Steve Mason, right-handed catcher. Michael Hutchinson, right-handed catcher. Think about it. Illuminati, Cup coming to Philadelphia if they make that trade in 2018.
I'm with Dan on that. I'm with Dan on that sound. My face, I went to go make that sound and you made it for me.
No? No, you don't think Michael Hutchinson and Steve Mason is a duo?
I don't think that's a Stanley Cup duo.
That's the fact that you possibly could have found.
That's why people listen, Dan.
We had like a minute on the podcast earlier that took us to name the five defensive prospects for Philly. Like, Greg and I were like, wait, is it this guy? It's been
a weird episode. We're 81 episodes into this thing and we still haven't perfected our craft.
If you want to look at the five Philly D prospects, you probably have to dip into the starting roster.
This is true because Gossifer is there.
Well, then, fine. It's down to four of them. That's fine with me.
Did you catch the Stadium Series game, Dan?
I caught a bit of it.
And what did you think? Chicago looked good again for the 900th time they've been in.
They got pumped.
I know they got pumped, but they're still in it every fucking year.
Oh, you're just uppity then.
Bitter.
It's kind of unfair that Chicago is in one every year, because I'm pretty sure they're going to be in one next year again.
They're going to be probably in the Winter Classic. I don't know. They'll be in something.
Greg's mad that Toronto didn't get anything for their 100th year. Not one thing, except the Cup.
They're not winning the cup next year. I'm not that
delayed. Steven Stamkos.
Aren't they getting an outdoor game next year?
Nope.
No, they got shafted.
They got shafted.
I thought they were getting one against Detroit in Toronto.
Yeah,
nope. Nope. Why would they do that? That would make way too much sense. Nope.
All right.
Do you have any fun facts about Phil Kessel, since it's a Phil Kessel-based podcast today with number 81?
Fun facts. Not really. I mean...
How does he make you feel inside?
I watched on the way back from my scouting report yesterday on the plane, I watched the worst plays of the month for January, and he was on about three of them. So
That's perfect.
That's a perfect stat for Filthy Phil Kessel.
So, aside from that, I can't really offer you much. I don't know.
Did you follow Jonathan Taves on Twitter? Because he joined.
He did.
I haven't, but I saw that he joined on the weekend. So
did you see what he said to Andrew Shaw?
I didn't.
Andrew Shaw like tweeted him saying, welcome to like the 20th cent, whatever. Making fun of him for not having Twitter. And then he just said, shut up, you little puke. And get your mind focused in the game today.
And then Taves can make fun of him for being the only reason that Andrew Shaw is not on the fourth line.
No, that's what Taves said to Shaw. And I think Taves could also say, yeah.
Dan is just vicious today. You got a lot of pent-up anger from that scouting report.
You clearly got to come back to the podcast, and we're looking forward to having you.
I'm not angry. I saw some things on the scouting report.
I want to hear those private stories that we can't share on the podcast.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, yeah. I have lots.
Okay, I want to hear them. Cool, I'm looking forward to this.
Excellent.
Okay, so we'll talk to you next week then.
All right.
Okay.
Do you have closing?
Yeah.
Oh, predictions. You can name five guys you think will not be with their team as next time we start the podcast.
And one of them has to be an off-the-board pick.
Oh, okay. Okay, well, for on the board, I'll say Andrew Ladd.
There is any Leaf available as well. Except for
Justin Schultz.
Oh. What was that?
Does it have to be like a big player? Or could it be anybody?
No, anyone.
Anyone. I'll say Dale Weiss.
Okay.
Dan's on the ball right now. With the rumors right now. I have no idea what's going on. I haven't been on
then
anything
take,
recently.
Take your off the board one. Go
off
right
the board,
now.
Go.
Here we go.
Off the board. Maybe it's not that off the board. Eric Staal.
Wow. Ah, yours were way better than ours. Ours sucked. Ours were like
Michael Grabner.
I said PA Parento and any Leaf, and then Greg said pick a flyer on a guy, and I'm like, and I thought he meant literally a flyer, so I picked Mark Streit. All right, we'll see you next week, there, Dan. Thanks for the report.
All right,
see you later.
Please listen this week. It's on YouTube. I don't know if you know how to find it. It's last minute.
Yeah, I'm already. Yeah, I love it.
Okay. So what do we got to finish off with?
Well, I have a couple random things, tidbits. You want signings, injuries? Did you want some weird random stuff? What do you want?
Give me injuries.
Give me injuries. Michael Delzato out for the rest of the season with surgery.
Yeah, I don't care about Flyers. I want real meaningful
Tom
injuries.
Gilbert out for the season.
No, don't know who he
surgery.
Is. Don't care.
David DeHarnett, 3 weeks, broken foot.
Ooh, that one sucks.
Ryan O'Reilly, 3 to 4 weeks, lower body injury. Brian Ooh. Elliott, 4 weeks, lower body injury. Jonathan Huberdeau has got a concussionis.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Milestones. Yammer Yager, third all-time in goals, 742 goals.
We didn't talk about that. We should talk about that.
We could. Let's do it right now.
Yammer Yager. Going to play till he's 80?
80? He's 44 right now.
He's got 44 more years in him. 44 more years.
Realistically, I could see him playing for at least
36 more years.
I think he's going to pass number two all-time in goals, which would be Gordie Howe at 801. It's realistic. If he hits 30 this year, what is he? How many? 8 away from 30 or something? Yeah. 9 away? That's only 3 more seasons of 20 goals. And on the team he's on right now, wouldn't they keep re-upping him for 1 year, like 2 mil? I'd do it. You're living in Florida on a beach, I'm assuming.
Not only are you living in Florida on a beach, you're playing on a team that's contending every year. Although the problem that they're going to have is they've got an aging goaltender in net, and how much longer can he stay in his prime?
Until that contract's over, obviously. That's how contracts work.
Ilya Kovalchuk might become a Toronto Maple Leaf.
Oh, yeah, let's hop back on that.
That was just a speculative thing I saw on Facebook today.
Because he got removed from SKA Petersburg because he's old and useless. And he's slow. No, I don't actually know why. I'm just talking out of my ass.
There is no way that I think the Kovalchuk comes back, because if he does, he needs approval of all 30 teams. There's no fucking way New Jersey's going to say yes to that.
Why? The guy who wanted him there was Lou Lamoriello. He's now on the lease. Oh
my God, I didn't think about that.
Sudden changes. Sudden changes. Who wouldn't want to play with Kovalchuk? Put him between Willie Hockey and Austin Matthews. Who cares?
No, put him between Steven Stamkos and Willie Hockey.
Well, I could see it.
No, maybe.
I don't want to see it. I lied. I don't want to see that.
What if Kovalchuk comes back and plays in our alumni game next year, though?
That's where the only Wait. Ice time he's getting in the NHL.
Question
next year.
For the alumni game next year.
Yep.
Do they wear Winnipeg Jet jerseys or do they go and wear Atlanta Thrasher jerseys?
They better wear Atlanta Thrasher jerseys.
Minnesota, in their alumni game, wore the North Stars.
Fine, then wear the Jets ones, but I think it's stupid. They have. Who wouldn't want Ray Ferraro on their team? And other guys.
Patrick Stephon?
Patrick Stephon and Boris Valabik. And
part of the Mark Stewart.
Rich Peverly. Could play. Oh, man. No wonder they want to use Winnipeg. This sucks so bad. Ugh. Is Bobby Hull going to play for the Jets?
Oh, God. Could you imagine? they just bring back everybody that was in the Avco Cup days. Just yeah. Like, let's just bring back our WHA team.
Let's only bring back the team that anyone cared about.
Hey, people cared about Tamu. And okay, be honest. Would they get Tamu? Would Tamu come back just to play a game here?
Yes.
How... Would you go alumni game if Tamu was there?
No. We've talked about the last podcast.
No, we talked about going to the actual game. I mean alumni
game. Not alumni game. It's in the same package as...
I don't care. I'd fucking go just to watch Tamu. He'd be worth it for me. I'd cry.
Okay. That is one of my favorite memories, watching Tamu come back the first time, because people reacted real good. But let's put it into perspective. Tamu Selanne, not that good. He wasn't that good. Took him how many years to win a cup? Oh, wait, he had to wait for Corey Perry and Ryan Getzlaff to win a cup. Oh, yeah, right. He only had 17 straight games in a streak as a rookie on a pretty loaded team. Well, Shane Goss despair. 15 games, essentially on his own. By the way, of his 12 goals that he scored this year, 4 of them are overtime game winners. The Philadelphia franchise record for overtime game winners, 6 as a franchise. And he has 4 this year. And of the remaining 8 goals that he scored, has either tied the game, been a go-ahead goal, or a game winner. So guess what? Fuck you, Timo Selanne. Ghost Bear. You feel that burn? You feel like that hate he's getting on Twitter? Oh, mama!
That was the last remains of 16-year-old Cam just saying bye-bye. Now the evil Cam is now...
He's gone over. Now. He's evil.
Stuff that was good about Cam is gone.
Yeah. Timo Selanne, I don't know. Yeah, sure, he's okay. I don't think he was, like, amazing or anything. I mean, they put him on the ice when they needed goals and whatnot, and he didn't really come through. You tell me. I'm just trolling, guys. He's awesome.
I know you are. You're just being a dick to one of the best players to ever set foot in the Winnipeg Arena.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? Do you have anything else to say? Because we had a comment from last week. And I'm tired of this person commenting on us. How dare you? Swift Bass Beats. I think it's bass. How do you spell bass in music terms? B-A-S-S? Give me that bass. Greg, pay attention.
Sorry.
Swift Bass Beats.
Oh, okay.
He commented, or she, I'm not sure. I think it's a he. Thanks for talking about where you wear your rings when we can't see what you're showing, LeMayo. Good podcast, by the way. That's how you give comments. You tear us down, then you give smooch on the tip of the nostril.
Well, you know what? Like... Eventually we can do this. The problem is we switch locations too much to like have a camera.
That means Cameron's got to do more work. Cameron's already losing sleep, guys. All right. Greg and Dan, they just show up.
Yep.
This is Kay. If we're talking like workmen, I am the Ryan Suter to our Minnesota Wild playoff run. That's what Cameron is to the podcast. No, I'm just kidding. We all put in our own work. Greg.
Sorry, I'm texting.
Let's close her up then.
Okay.
Let's close up. If you're not giving 100,
I'm not giving
we're 100. Giving none 100.
We're giving none 100? None 100.
Close her up. Okay. Closing words.
Next week, we've got a very exciting episode. We're going to talk about the unveiling. Oh, we won't even be able to talk about. Are we didn't do this on Wednesday? We should do this on Wednesday because the unveiling of the World Cup jerseys will be
on. We do it on Monday because Cameron's at concerts the rest of the week. So Monday it is.
Okay, so next week we're just going to talk about trades that happened.
Again!
That's it. But before we finish, the election for this week.
Oh, give me that sweet, sweet election news. While you're getting the election ready, the Ottawa 67s had to postpone a game due to a leaky roof.
And the Flint Firebirds fired their coach again.
Oh, man, let's not even delve into that situation. Jeez. They did have a Flint Tropics night, though.
Did they?
Yeah, before they fired everyone again.
Did they bring him back at least?
Again? Why would they bring him back again? They fired him again. I don't know what's happening. I don't want to get into it. Google it yourself. We're not a podcast. You don't know us.
We're a podcast, Cameron.
We are.
Okay. Starting at the number five worst team in the league.
Okay.
Calgary Flames.
Okay.
Buffalo Sabres.
Okay.
Winnipeg Jets.
Who?
Toronto Maple Leafs.
Up in the MIMCO.
Who's the last team?
Ed Money, of course. Exactly. Why the hell not? You can't suck for that long. Piss off. It's not fair. They're doing what the 76ers are doing, just unintentionally. I don't know if it's intentional, or the 76ers have intentionally tanked for so long that now they're like, their fans aren't even listening on the radio or TV. You're just ruining, you're damaging the image of your hockey team at that point, or your franchise. Like, what are you doing? Guess we worked up. I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
Closing words, Greg.
Thank you for listening to episode 81. We might have
really kept your attention for like a minute.
Yeah. Apologize. We'll be back to our normal selves next week.
Yeah, Dan's here to bring a realist right back in.
Exactly. Let's hope. Except Cam's schedule fucks us up. So.
Oh, it's my fault.
Your fault.
Okay, see you later, guys.
Check us out on YouTube.
And? YouTube and?
Wherever you listen to your podcast. Twitter and email.
And friendship.
And friendship.